Okay.
Carl will be doing his 10th and final speech of the Competent Communicator.
Mr. Toastmaster.
Carl.
Well, I am very pleased to be here this evening to do my 10th speech because I have worked very hard to get through 10. That was a goal that I set for myself, so I'm going to go home and have a beer right after this. The name of my speech is Let Go, Let Flow. Let Go, Let Flow. In my book, 21 Steps to Magnificent Living, one of the very first chapters is about how to remain in flow. Flow, I use that as an acronym, and that is faith, love, optimism, and wisdom. And I tell people that as you go through your day, as you go through your life, our goal is always to try to stay in that positive flow state. But every now and then, like we all know, we get what I call flow stoppers. And this week, I experienced a flow stopper, and it was disturbing and upsetting, and it ended up being funny all by the end of it. The red folder. This red folder has been haunting me all week. And almost like it's talking to me, it keeps saying, another level, another devil, another level, another devil. And maybe that's why it's red. And I'm serious. I mean, I'm scary enough. I sold my business when I left Washington, D.C. And I sold my business to two people I met. I actually decided that I was going to close my business. I was ready to move to Maui. I was just going to sell my stuff and close my business. But when you have a business, I don't know if you've ever had one, it becomes like a child to you. So what I didn't want to do was throw the baby out with the bathwater. So I decided to try to find someone to buy my business. So two people came to me and they agreed to buy the business and we signed the contract and I made a really soft contract. Pay me back in the course of 2 years. You can pay me back as little as $300 a month. And that's all I ask. The first month they missed their payment. The second month they missed their payment. The third month they made their payment. The fourth month they didn't make their payment. The fifth month I had to call them. By the 6th month, they had just decided that they were going to stop paying me and stop calling me and stop answering my phone calls and my texts. And all the bills kept piling up into this red folder. These were all the bills that I had from the old business that were supposed to be paid by what happened when I sold the business. So the red folder was in front of me, and I couldn't flow right, and I couldn't flow left, and I couldn't flow forward. I felt like I was just trying to get in front of this red folder. And I was in the house and it was driving me crazy. What am I going to do with this red folder? So I put it down and I do what I always do. I took my problems to the ocean. And I sat there and I watched the ocean and I watched the waves roll out and I watched them roll back in and I watched them roll out and I watched them roll back in. And all of a sudden the ocean said to me, you didn't stay in flow. And that's the reason why you're having the problem. So I said to the ocean, well, what do you mean by that, ocean? And it said, you didn't use your wisdom. When you didn't use your wisdom, because you know that if you sell your business, you should have told them, you pay me now. There is no soft contract. No one gave me a soft contract. I went in, I borrowed money, and I suffered to pay it back. So I didn't use my wisdom. So what my wisdom did, just like the waves, the wisdom rolled back on my optimism. And then my optimism was crushed. And this was pressing on my optimism. And then the waves rolled back again, and it crushed my love. And I no longer loved the fact that I would go on Facebook and I would see them holding my equipment, doing exercises. How cute is this? But they didn't pay for it. So I was watching them hold my baby online and let that disturb my flow. But this is what the ocean said to me. If life brought it to you, if life brings you a problem, it's something that you need to fix. And often, I don't listen to my wisdom. So what I want to inspire you with this evening is, in order to stay in your flow, approach it with faith, approach it with love, hold on to your optimism, but use your wisdom, because just like waves, if you don't use all four, they'll roll back, just like the waves and crash on each other. I want to inspire you to stay in flow and stay focused on flow, knowing that moving forward is the only place that we're going. So that when you have that red folder that is holding you back, It's only things that, the only thing that I can do with this is fight it, change it, or change the way I feel about it. I choose to fight it, but I'm going to fight it, but I'm going to let it go. I'm going to give it to an attorney so that I can remain in my flow. I'd like to thank you so much for listening to me one more time. And you won't have to do it for a couple of weeks at least. Thank you.
Thank you. I like it. I think I used the word opportunity in the porch light flow.
Did you?
I should just say.